Hello traders, let's take a quick look at the trading system and try to untangle this beautiful mess. The trading system is called Ichimoku Kinko Hyo, and in a decade or so it will have 100 years. It is created in the 1930s by a journalist that designed it to gauge the properties of a market, and it is mostly a trend following system. So what we see here is how a ranging market looks like generally, and the handful of elements this trading system has are basically what draws these lines on the chart and what we will use in our trading. So the trading system has mainly five components, and they are still called unknown and used by their original Japanese name. These elements are two lines on this chart drawn in magenta and purple that are behaving almost like moving averages, and we'll see how they are constructed. The magenta one is called Tenkan Sen, the purple one is called Kijun Sen, and another one on this chart in silver or light gray that is called Chiku Span. Their names is not very important. What is important to remember is how they are constructed, what they mean, and how we can use them in order to trade this trading system. Besides these three lines, we see construction that is not very common in technical analysis. In this case, this construction is practically a space in between two lines that takes one color or another, depending on whether the trend is mostly up or mostly downward. The formation is known as the Kumo cloud, and the two lines that define these colored formations, these clouds, are named Sinku Span A and Sinku Span B. Now, trying to understand how a signal looks like, what a signal signifies, and if we should trade that signal, can be done after we understand how these lines are formed. So, starting from M1 chart, we see that the noise in the market is practically something that hardly can be understood, and this trading system, that is by design a trend following system, works better on higher time frames. So we'll move to the time frames the system has a chance to work in, and we'll see how it looks and whether or not it's something we could use. In this market, for example, we are looking at the first two lines we've talked about. The first one is called Tenkan Sen, the other one The other one is Kijun Sen. Tenkan Sen, yes, is a line that takes its value by calculating and plotting on the chart the highest high and the lowest low over the last 9 periods. In this case, the value we see here on the end of the chart is basically the value of the Tenkan Sen is the highest high and the lowest low over the nine periods as an average. The other line is drawn and calculated in a similar manner and is the highest high and the lowest low over the last 26 periods. So these two lines move along, one being a short-term momentum indicator, the other one being a medium-term momentum indicator. They act also, they may act also as support or resistance, as we see here, for example, and they move much like a moving average, but not quite like a moving average, because by design they are not moving averages, they are averages of the highest high and the lowest low over a certain periods back. A moving average takes into consideration either the close price or the open price or the low price or the high price, but only one price every time. In this case, the lines are taking an average of two values that are the highest high and the lowest low over the certain number of periods back, which sometimes result on charts in some horizontal lines that can act as support, as it is the case here, for example.
To see more, please subscribe, give us a thumb up and share our clips.